Welcome to Pro Se Legal School. We provide the tools. You do the punching. Work. You do the work. I get a little carried away with that punching. Welcome to my video today. In today's video, I'm going to outline some updates that we need to discuss concerning stopping the foreclosure eviction process. And so we're going to talk about that today and a couple of other things. So as you guys probably noticed from the last video that I posted, some of the kids in the neighborhood found out that I have a YouTube channel and they made their first video yesterday. It came out pretty cool. I might let them come back and make another. They were so excited yesterday. And I also got to meet Tucker's cousin, Wendy. She came over and they came over to see if I was working on if I had gotten the video finished. They were very patient, though. And so Wendy subscribed to my channel. Name is Shark something something. I don't know. I haven't had a chance to go and subscribe to her channel yet. But Wendy, I will subscribe to your channel, too. I like to subscribe to all the people who subscribe to my channel, as long as you're not saying too many bad words. I'm glad your parents let you guys watch me. I hope I'm not saying too many bad words. I'm going to try to clean that up a little bit so that people can, maybe not hear one or two bad words. Anyway, let's get rolling. So a couple of things we want to talk about. Today's video, we're going to talk about updating the eviction situation, how to stop the eviction process, and be more clear. There were two ways we were doing that. And the first way that we figured out wasn't the best way for the people that were facing being pushed off the cliff. So we have a second way, and we talk about that. But we're going to go over that today. One of the things that I wanted to touch on is the coaching group. Now, I've decided to let people who, my private coaching group, I have a lot of paralegals and legal coaches or people who are using my products to help other people in that group. So I decided to let anybody in the group that invest in the program. Now, the group is my private coaching group. It's not a place where you can go and ask people for what they did or what document they think is best for something or whatever, okay? And the reason for that is what I'm teaching here, I'm still learning. That's why we're doing updates. I'm learning from the people in the group, the real-time feedback, and not only from people in the group, from people outside the group that participate in our program. So I'm still learning things that reflects the updates that you need to do. Now, if you get in my program, updates are where you need to start, okay? The updates are where you need to start, because all of that stuff that we was doing before, the corrections are the update, if you get what I'm saying. I have people contact me, hey, I didn't get the jurisdiction document in my thing, or I didn't get this document, I didn't get that document. Well, you got the documents that you're supposed to get in the package that you invested in. What happens is people watch the old videos, and then when they get to the package, they think the stuff in old videos should be in the package. Now, those people need to get the hell caught up to speed, okay? If you invested in a package, you got what you need in that package to do what you need to do. The only reason this could be a problem for you is if you think you need to do other stuff, and then you think you need the stuff that was in the old package back there that we don't use anymore because we got our ass kicked. So I'm just saying. So stick with the program. If you get in my program, you can't just do, you can do whatever you want, okay? But the program's going to work best for you if you do what is the updated instructional video to follow along. You can't look at the video from 2 years ago and decide that's what you need to do. I want to get in the program so I can do that. Because we don't do that. We want to keep it looking forward. And this is what I tell people. You're looking backwards now. People are messaging me all this stuff before they did, whatever. I don't care about that. Because we're not doing that. We're going after them for the day-to-day state process and procedures that they're doing to line you up in their shit. That's what we're going after them for. Not the lies and the uniqueness of your whatever, okay? None of that matters. Hell, it don't even matter if you're in foreclosure or property tax or lien. It don't matter. Okay, so what matters is, did they deliver your deed to you? No, they didn't. They didn't deliver your damn deed to you. They made a copy of it, and they sent you that copy, which is We're going after them for the process that started at the gate when they failed to deliver your deed to you as mandated in their state law. So that's what we're going to be going after them. Now, today, what I want to talk about is oh, wait, a couple more things. I have 5,000 subscribers now. Yay! Thank you, everyone, for subscribing and being a part of this program. So now YouTube has allowed me to have my own Shopify store on here. I thought I had it set up yet, but I don't see it. So I'm still getting that set up. So in my Shopify store, I'm going to have all my lawsuit packages or whatever, just like it's on my website. Now people won't have to go to the from here, over there, back over there. Well, still got to do some over there to the YouTube. but it's better than going over there to store your shit in storage. So we're going to set that up. I want you guys to when I get the store set up, I'll definitely make videos and let you know. And I'll probably have a playlist for the store so I can have comments in and what people have to say about it and all of that. So, and still working on the new package. We're getting it lined out now, making the corrections or whatever. So when people invest in my program, I like it, them to be able to just change the word, you know, to add the defendant's names and their addresses. And it's not a whole lot else you need to change. It's not a lot else you need to change because you need to remember you're going after them for the day-to-day process and procedures that they use to line you up in their administrative court. And that started with their failure to deliver your stinking deed to your house. And if you're in criminal situation, the problem is that they have no injured party or damaged property, so the court doesn't have judicial authority to be in your face. But they are. So you can just, and I already have another prosecutor eliminated package was designed exactly for that criminal crap. And this attorney eliminated package is exactly the same, except it has one or two more documents. I have a badass document that Nikki Ross reminded me about to strike the attorney's notice of appearance. And another part, that's the 1, 2, 3. that's the 1, 2, 3. And it's that document by itself is pretty powerful. And so we're going to set this up so people can use that new attorney eliminator package to eliminate the attorneys in the face. Now, in my program, you're only limited by your imagination or your fear, your imaginary fear. Oh yeah, that sounds pretty good. Your imaginary fear, because that's what it is. You're fearful of what happened to you back there. But since we're not doing the same thing that you was doing back there, which is getting your ass kicked, you shouldn't be worried. So we're going to be getting things done going forward. The eviction situation, if you're facing the eviction process, okay, we're learning how to stop the state court process before you get stuff filed in federal court. What we found is that the federal court was stalled the process, you know, judge having a baby, and oh wait, the judge is, judge has transient, okay, never mind. So what we found is that the federal court was stalled, so we need to figure out a way to smash the state court process before we even filed in federal court. And that's what we're doing now by adding the state, the judge, and the attorney who signed to start all this mess to your either counterclaim is how this started, but you can only do the counterclaim if you have plenty of time and they're not already in the eviction process. And the reason is the counterclaim, they're the ones that are going to have to like rule on it. Well, they're not going to rule on it. It's going to mess them up because they can't litigate a case they're a party to. They can't represent themselves or whatever. But then they'll go into the stall mode and try to get and move the eviction process up and try to get your ass out of the property before. Yeah, so we had to change that. So if you're facing a foreclosure eviction process now, what you need to do is take that 42 USC 1983, the federal lawsuit, change the heading on the top for state, put the players in there that you need, include the people, I'm working on it. Include the eviction people in there, and you need to file that in state court as a claim. And I think it's, what, $200 or whatever. What we found is the only way to stop the eviction process is to do this. Because, well, we were doing it the other way, but then federal court stalled and gave them time. So we had to figure out another way to do it. And so that's what we've done. If you are facing the eviction process, you do not have time to file the counterclaim. You do not have time to worry about moving the case to federal court. That's old. That's old. And here's why. Number one, statute's not a valid law because it doesn't have an acting clause to tie a lower body. So the foreclosure statute that you just take your shit. Okay, so that's number one. And number two, the court don't have jurisdiction to hear any of that stuff. And you need to make sure that you stop the state court in the state court tracks. Now, in the end, and this is why it's important to do everything according to the instruction video until you get control of this thing, and then you can start but it's important that you got to do everything according to, because in the end, you will be able to use the fact that they are not able to respond to the state court beatdown. You're going to use that to force the federal judge to order them fools to come to the table with settlement hearings. Because look, here's the thing. If they can't respond to anything that you file against them in state court, then they have no standing to argue anything in federal court. And so you always want to approach this from the perspective of the court. Okay, so like, yeah, I'd be like, yeah, judge, you need to order their bus to come here and settlement hearings because they haven't responded to any of the court, state court beat down. They haven't responded to the state court beat down that they received. So they have no standing to be in federal court answering to anything that I got on the table. And as far as the evidence, there's no evidence needed because their state process, their day-to-day process is what you're suing them for. You know, the fact that, come on, say it with me, they failed to deliver your deed, so they committed real estate defraud. That's the only damn thing that I want to talk about. If you are talking to the judge or the clerk or any of those people, that's it. Real estate deed fraud. Real estate deed fraud. You're a conspirator to real estate. Real estate deed fraud. Yep, all of, okay, maybe you might not want to go with everybody. they might be calling security on your ass if you went with everybody. But anyway, so there you go with that. And the other reason why you don't have to worry about moving your stuff over to federal court is because you're going to go over there and you're going to file your lawsuit in federal court against the state court players. So that's the movement right there. There's no moving that because when you sue the judge can't bond to... Now, the judge has to recuse him or herself and hire someone to litigate this over in the state court, over in the federal court, excuse me, over in the federal court where you just... I don't see how they're going to, you know, get out of that. Oh, wait, yeah, I got a lot of happy people that have bought my stuff. As a matter of fact, I'm the only legal service that has good reviews. Okay, I have more than... Okay, anyway, so... So you need to understand if you're facing an eviction process, and don't worry about trying to move the case, and don't, you know, what you need to do is add the people to the lawsuit and file it in state court as a claim. So you're going to have to file two lawsuits to get the eviction shit stopped, and that's sad as hell, but that's the way it is. That's the way it is. And the people that are doing that are the people that are, you know. Now, the other thing that people need to consider doing is filing. The other thing that I would do is file a less penalty lien against your property after you get done with your lawsuit, because you'll need to have your lawsuit. You'll need a certified copy of your lawsuit in most states. Now, you need to look up your state and see what their requirement is. But you know, the little bit of research that I've done on the less pendants lien shows that, you know, a lot of states are different. They have different stuff just to be a pain in the ass so they can try to make it complicated for you. But you need to have a certified copy of your lawsuit to file in the county deeds office or recorder's office, wherever the hell it is to have your deed, because you want to have that claim that less penalty lien filed against your property for your lawsuit and all the stuff that they've done. And you know, I mean, I'm just sitting here thinking about this off the top of my head. And if I'm facing criminal process, shoot, I'd file the lien against their case. And their case is already filed in court. So you could take their criminal case in court, get a certified copy of it. And I don't know why you couldn't do that. And then file your own. And that is free. Uh-huh. Think about it. And see, this is the beauty of the unconventional program. It's only limited by your imagination or your fear. So if you come in with a big imagination and check the fear at the curb, yeah, you could be doing this too. Yep. That's an interesting. File your lien against the criminal case. It doesn't have to be a less penis lien. You can just file a lien. You can file a damn mechanics lien because they got your straw man hostage. Okay, that's a whole nother video. So I want you guys to remember that if you're facing the eviction process, you have to file your lawsuit in state court first as a state lawsuit. And then when you file over in federal court, your regular lawsuit in federal court, your federal lawsuit in federal court with a federal court. And you won't even need to move anything over because they're not going to want to hear none of they're not going to want to hear none of this. They're going to put pressure on them fools to get this stuff out of their court. So that's where they're going. Believe me, I've been through it. And that's why my program's so badass. So that's the big thing that we need to do, the correction that we need to make for the eviction process. You're facing a foreclosure eviction process. You got to file your lawsuit in state court after you add the players that you're supposed to add already, plus the players from the eviction court. And hell, you can even add the players from the sale barn or whatever. You know, because remember, the state court crap, you're not going to litigate on state court. You can ask many people to that as you want to, in my opinion, because you're not going to have to answer to all those people, whatever. And when you move over to the federal court people are going to press them fools in state court to get this out of their face. And state court's going to say, oh, we got this. We just need you to give us some time to get to the eviction process. They're not going to have that time when you file a brand new case. And this is the reason why they can't send you back to state court. They can't send you back to state. The federal judge cannot dismiss your case and send you back to state court unless you're stupid. I'm just saying, no offense. Because it's a federal case filed in federal court. It's not a state case that was moved. Oh, now you see why we don't worry about moving it. Uh-huh. Because they automatically would send it back just to screw with your head. So we don't do that no more. We figured out a way to get this happen. So if they try that, I mean, it's easy. Now I'm just going to sue the federal judge. Usually it's a magistrate judge, and the magistrate judge doesn't have authority to be involved in a case without a signature from all the parties. I have a magistrate judge playlist with that anyway. Yeah, but usually if the judge helps them, then we're going to add the judge to the cha-ching chang and serve them a notice of claim or add them to the lawsuit, depending on how pissed off they made you. I'm just saying, if you don't punch them in the face, literally, when they throw you under the bus to help their buddies, you may well just lock yourself up or throw your shit in the yard yourself. And I'm hoping this is going to clear this up, because this is a big step. I talked to someone just the other day, and they said, bless their heart, they said, yeah, we can't wait to move it. No, we're not moving it, because they sent it back. You need to crush it, and then get your lawsuit filed in federal court so they can't move. Now, here's the biggest thing why they can't move it, even if you have moved it over there from state court. And the reason why they can't move it is because the state court judge has damn conflict of interest. Oh, wait, I could trust the other judges? The state court judge's buddies? No. Keep it simple. State court has conflict of interest. So the only other court y'all ask to send me to is up. Nah, not down. Y'all can send me to the Supreme Court, to the Appeals Court. I don't know. Send me. They ain't trying to do that. They don't even want it in their court. So, and there you have it. So, thank you guys for the value of sharing your time. Make sure you click on that video about my kids, about my neighborhood kids. They're like my grandkids. I think I have a bunch of white grandkids in the whole neighborhood. Anyway, as you guys can see, I enjoy spending time with kids and helping them grow. You never know. They might be making that $1 million and pass me up, so I need to be nice to them. You guys click on those kids' videos so that they can see that you guys are watching them grow. Thank you for the virus sharing your time. I'll see you guys in the next video.